last night, well, it was Tuesday, when I saw Rudy, one of my favorite poets, posted on Instagram that he's going to be performing in Atlanta on the 24th. So I'm like, he's gonna come to DC. So I'm like, he hadn't posted a schedule or anything. So I'm like, if he comes to DC, I'll just see him again. But you know what? I'm going to Atlanta to see him perform. And why don't I just make that a weekend getaway? So I booked the trip. In another woman that could take your spot, my love. Don't y'all love my vlog camera and my messy braids? Yeah. Hey, Alexa, what time is it?
It's 1:24 a.m.
Okay, yeah, about 1:30. I leave in 2 hours. And it's very me to not be packed right now. It's very me to not be fully packed right now, but we love a face that's breaking out. We love messy braids. I'm gonna hop in the shower. I don't know about you, but this looks like the face of someone who's gonna be traveling everywhere. So this is the first time I've even been in the airport since like second grade. I just stopped for some Starbucks. It's about, like, I'm cutting it close. It's like 20 more minutes till we're able to board on my plane or whatever. Why am I out of breath? Because my book bag is heavy. But who's excited for this vlog? But am I nervous about being on the plane? Not really. I probably will be when I actually get on it. But I'm just ready for this trip. Have you been drinking enough water? I haven't, and that's why my skin is breaking out. I just love it. So it's almost 3 p.m. now, but I got to my Airbnb, my room, around 12. Then I hopped in the shower. I've been chilling, and I'm currently doing work, as you can see. I was gonna take a nap. I got no sleep. I didn't sleep before I went on my flight because I didn't want to miss my flight. I'm excited to see Rudy tonight. He just posted something saying all the tickets are sold out and VIP gets to get in first, and they're opening doors at 7:10.
I'm gonna be there at 6:45.
But I also just ordered vegan food from a place called Rudata, so I'm gonna do a review on that.
I have to give this a 5 out of 10. I ordered the lasagna and coconut curry cauliflower stew along with a peanut passion drink. The only thing I liked was the drink. It was very just dry, kind of bland, not enough flavor, not saucy enough, and a waste of my money and my time and my chewing.
So I'm about to, you know, I'm getting ready. How should I greet Rudy? Because I have to have him, you know, sign his autograph on my two books that I have by him at the end. Should I be like, hey, I've been a huge fan for so long. I took your workshop. I don't know if you remember me, I'm Jackson, but I took your workshop in from January to February on Thursdays. Can I please have your autograph? Can we please take a picture? Can I get a hug? Can you write a love poem about me? So here's the look. Low-rise jeans, long sleeve top, even though it's 90-something degrees. We gonna be inside, so it don't matter. I wanted to be extra early, but I needed my nap, and that would be very off-brand for me to be extra early. But that's okay, because I got VIP tickets. So we get seating first, only up front.
Y'all, so no way, like no way. I'm about to really meet my favorite poet ever. Let me make sure I have my freaking. Bro, what if he calls me up there and I don't have my notebook on me? It's all good. Thank you.
gonna pay what he owe. Like, I was sick of dudes giving my house every year like we don't pay tithes. Like, we don't bake cookies. I mean, an old white man watching everything and coming back to bless you just for being nice never made sense in my neighborhood, but we learned to say our prayers anyway. Write our lists anyway because we wanted things. I wanted my mother off the naughty list. I want to know why she got to work every Eve, Xmas, and Boxing Day fighting to feed this family. I want to know how much fruit cake she got to make for her Jesus stop skipping his birthday party. I want to bite when my sister.
If you were here right now, I would massage your back until your skin sings songs that your lips don't even know the words to. Until your heartbeat sounds like my last name. See, I'm not much of a love poet. But if I was, I'd write about how you have the audacity to be beautiful, even on days when everything around you is ugly. I'd write about your eyelashes and how they are like violin strings that play symphonies every time you blink. If I was a love poet, I'd write about how I melt in front of you like an ice sculpture every time I hear the vibration in your voice. And whenever I see your name on the caller ID, my heart plays hopscotch inside of my chest. It climbs on.
So it's like midnight now and I just got back to my Airbnb. The event was freaking amazing. I just met one of my favorite poets ever. Yeah, nobody talked to me, just, no. And I look bomb. So he performed, you know, priority seating, I got that or whatever. It was a lot of people. His whole thing sold out. It was 200 tickets, whatever. I was on time anyways, because we were all outside the door before he got in. And he performed for about an hour. And then he was taking, you know, he was signing people's books, giving autographs, whatever, and taking pictures of people. The person who took my picture, what were you doing? The angle was horrible, but anyways, I got him to sign the two books I have that are his. Boom. Boom. And while, since the line was so long, he actually, I was talking to someone who had, he had pulled up to the stage to open for him. And his name is Chev, and he is a great Atlanta poet or whatever. So I'm talking to him, da 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 da. He's performing tomorrow night, and guess who else is performing tomorrow night? I'm so freaking nervous because, like, I'm new to the poetry scene and all these people are so talented. Am I a little bit intimidated? Because I'm like, no, I'm like, is my stuff even good enough to perform? Like, I'm just getting nervous, but it's getting very much imposter syndrome, but I feel lovely. I'm so happy I came out here, bro. Making new connections, meeting genuine people, and just, good night, I'm so tired. I met Rudy and he looked me in my eyes. Bro, I swear, like, we made eye contact when he was performing. We did. He's in love with me. I mean, it's like, let me chill out. But for real, hearing him in person was just amazing. And I was like, you gotta come to like DC soon or something like that. He said he's on his way there.
Okay guys, I'm up at 4 o'clock. It's like 12 now, but at 4 o'clock I'm going to a dance class. And that's outside, like a pole dancing class or whatever, from 4 to 7. And you know, we just bring snacks, we're gonna be chilling outside. But before that, I'm about to go to Playable Smoothie for Smoothie Bowl. And before that, I gotta go to Walgreens because the arm of my glasses broke off yesterday. And guess who doesn't have a screw? So I changed my top, but also this is a skort, so there's shorts under here, just in case. You know,
I'm so irritated. I took a lift to Walgreens and I made two stops. It was to Walgreens and then to Playables. I took too long at Walgreens, so he just canceled the ride. Whatever. I didn't even take that long. You could have waited a few more minutes. Whatever. So I get another lift from Walgreens to Playables. He drops me off right here. Don't see Playables, but I see this directory sign. So I go up to it to look for Playables. It doesn't say it. Then I look it up on my maps. It's saying Playables is 2 minutes away. so whatever. I start walking, 2 minute walk. I start walking around. I don't see it anywhere. Just tell me to go this way. Then tell me to go that way. There's no playables around. Where is it? So I'm irritated. And now I'm just sitting here until I figure out how to get there. I'm about to just get another lift. Because I'm not walking. It was taking me around like a garage or something like that. What is that? That lift driver's a weirdo, bro. So I'm probably crying for no reason, but I'm freaking lost. I was gonna call my dad, tell him I'm lost, but what is he gonna do? So I'm back at the same spot where I originally was. The Lyft driver dropped me off like back there, just like the other one did. So I'm walking. This is the same area. I'm following directions. He's telling me to come over here. Then you come down here to the garage. The reason I thought, I was like, because sometimes the Lyft driver, the Lyft app doesn't show the exact correct location. It'll show something nearby. I was like, would you be able to like put it in your maps or blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I'm giving you one fucking star. I was like, do you like just put it in your maps and see? Because I pulled up my maps. I was like, it's showing we're here, but it's really here. He's like, sorry, ma'am. I'm just, no, you're not sorry. So now I don't know what to do. All because I want playables.
So I got the green taco with potato and the chipotle taco with shrimp. I'll give it a 5 out of 10. They were cheap, obviously, but it was not saucy enough. And I needed more toppings on there. And I've had way better tacos than these. So I'm at Bell Street Burritos and I'm staying here before I head over to the dance class, which is outside. It's around 3:10 right now. I'm gonna eat these. It's 20 minutes away, so I'm gonna get there. I'm currently working on my villain poem. I don't know why I'm so intimidated and nervous about my performance tonight. Like, I'm even going back to when I first wrote it and seeing if, like, I don't know if there's, like, because I wrote around the different ideas to put in the poem, which I didn't. And all of a sudden, knowing I'm performing tonight and being around so many great poets, it's giving very much imposter syndrome. But also, I feel like there's so much more that I can add to it. And all of a sudden, I'm seeing everything that's wrong with the poem, even though I know I am a great poet and I'm still growing and still in my beginning stages. So I'm just excited for, like, it's like I'm a caterpillar right now with the poetry world, but I'm waiting for the butterfly effect. And honestly, I literally see myself performing with or opening for Rudy in the future. But I'm starting all over. I don't want to read while I'm performing because you won't feel as much passion. But I'm gonna try to memorize this before I go, which I can. This is the only poem I've memorized. So that's why I choose to do this one. Also, Villain is my favorite one. And I really don't have many performance poems. I mostly have page poems, so I need to get back to writing. Anyways, I haven't even been journaling lately, like not even in my gratitude journal, so I'm about to do that now.
Okay, we got Glacier's Italian Ice right here.
How y'all doing? How you doing? So I'm Matthew McKinney. I'm San Diego, California, Morehouse grad, 2012. Right now we have an entrepreneurship program where we employ the youth, we keep them safe, we educate, we employ, and we expose, right?
Okay.
So come on down to 2185 MLK, check us out. We got all the flavors, different sizes on the at the store.
And y'all, I had the mango flavor, and this is the best Italian ice I ever had. It's kind of creamy too, so it's really good. It's not crunchy and all icy with barely any flavor like most of the ones I've had before. Come and take your place, because the love you give, you can't be replaced. So go now, and think you do. That's why I'm mine, turn my life with you. Lyft is dumb. Put the driver in the wrong spot. He was trying to find me for 20 minutes. Ended up canceling because he couldn't find me from the dancing, whatever. So I just got ready. I was gonna wear my skirt and a crop top, but I'm bloated. Nah. Anyway, I'm gonna be late. I'm gonna be there like 8:20. The open mic list better still be open. Like, hopefully this is the one spot where it's like, yeah, we open at 7:30 and we said we open at 8, but everybody ain't here yet, so we're gonna start at 8:30.
I'll need a gun. It has a nice French twist, and I've been one before. No one wants to hear the bad guy side of the story, but don't we all love a bit of drama? Sit back, give everyone's accusations and call it truth. I'll be the monster under the dreamer's bed, because they're always too afraid to look under anyway. Solely enjoy the rush of being afraid of nothing.
All right, y'all, it's Sunday morning. Well, it's like 11 right now. Don't mind this. This is a stain that never went away, no matter how many times I clean it. But yesterday performing, I was really nervous, really anxious, because they saved me for last, and then I messed up, but that's okay. I'm so proud of myself for putting myself out there, whatever. This is the look for today. I was gonna wear like my jersey top, but it's too hot for that. So this will do. And I'm about to head to brunch with a woman I met at Rudy's performance, Rudy's show. So we're going to a vegan spot called True Food Kitchen. There's also one in Maryland, but I've never been to it, but I'm ready to eat. And we're supposed to meet at 10:30, but I just finished getting ready.
All right, say hey, Ari.
Hey. Good morning.
Yes, we got our wellness shots.
We're here, happy Sunday fun day.
Yep.
Episode 4.
Spinach and mushroom pizza. This looks good. You got dumplings, cauliflower, and kale salad. Shopping. You ready for tonight?
I am.
So I decided to get a veggie burger with french fries. I'll give it a cool 6.5. It was good. All right, we just stopped at Ulta. Ari needed some makeup for tonight. We're gonna have a great time, and right now we're just waiting for the list. So we're gonna be separated for a few hours.
Just a few.
It's like 11 p.m. and I got my dress on. I got shorts under because, yeah, and I got these shoes. I got them for $60. I love a sale, and that's why I bought them. And guess what Ari got me, y'all? A book, How to Talk to Anyone, 92 Little Tricks for Big Success in Relationships. That's so freaking cute. Nobody knows how much, like, little book gifting, whatever that means. Like, just giving me a book that they think I'll love, or just, wow. It's a thoughtfulness. And she was like, you know, because she actually approached me after Rudy's show, and we were talking a little bit, and I mean, I see a good friendship blooming from this.
Turn me inside out, make my heart beat. Leave no one else.
It's the last day. Ooh, it's the last day. In Atlanta, made some good friends and had a good time. Everything I want, yeah, it's already mine. Please don't play with me, stay out of my way. Cause no matter when, I'ma have a good day. On my way to the aquarium, gonna wear blue. And I don't care about you, cause I'm a da da da. All right, it's 8:28, I'm about to hop in the shower, be ready by 9:30 the latest. Head to the aquarium. So if I get there at like 9:45 and I stay till like 12, head back here, get to the airport by 1 the latest, because my flight takes off at 3, so it's not bad. Can't even think right now. I met so many great people. I connected with so many genuine people. I love Ari. I'm glad she asked me to hang out. I'm glad we met. We had a great time last night. We had a great time all yesterday. I spoiled myself this weekend like I deserve. Okay, this is the aquarium fit. It's like 10:30 now. I took forever getting ready because I still had to get packed. I thought I wasn't gonna have time to go to the aquarium, but I'm making time.
should have came earlier. These are weedy sea dragons that look like seaweed.
Oh, wow.
And the males carry the eggs on his tail until it hatches. That's so cool. What the heck?
I used to love penguins, and I didn't even have a reason for loving them. I just love them. So I'm about to read all these.
This is everyone for the dolphin show. That's crazy. My flight takes off in about an hour, but I got a vegan salad from Nature's Table Bistro and fruit salad. So I'm at the BWI right now, which is the Baltimore airport, and I don't want to go home, but I'm about to get my bags. How do I feel? I feel like I'm grateful that I even have the means to be able to be like, oh, one of my favorite poets is performing out there. Let me just pack up and go. Not everybody can do that. I'm glad I have the means to be able to travel and save money and do what I love. This is the first of many, 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 many trips. This is the first travel vlog of many, 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 many more. And it just makes me happy that I'm able to just pack up and go. This solo trip was successful. I met a lot of great people. I talked to a lot of great people, connected to a lot of great people, even my Lyft drivers. I always love when I order a Lyft or something to have a great conversation with my driver, but that happens a lot. And that happened a lot in Atlanta, and I met Ariana. I'm happy about that. We had a great time. I'll be back in Atlanta in the fall, but overall, I'm just very grateful to God, and I'm so happy, and more will be coming, more great things. We're only halfway through this year, and this is only the first trip, so we'll have to see. I can see us holding hands, walking on the beach, our toes in the sand. I can see us on the countryside.